Hello, Paddy, I'm talking to you. Listen to me. Baha, baha. Take your machine gun, fire the people. Geji, geji, geji. Hi, guys. How are you all doing? I hope you are having a fabulous day so far. Look at the scarf. Girl, this looking on point. I don't know what y'all are talking about, but I'm on point, right? Y'all are on point, too. All right, so Ghana tag, yay. All right, so I'm going to talk about, you know, things that Ghanaian mothers tell their daughters, you know, their married daughters. Like, if you are married, what your mom tells you. Trust me, I don't know if you're Ghanaian. I'm sure probably, and if you are married, your mom has had this conversation with you. And if you're not married, I get that you are having the pressure, but don't worry. It's all in God's hands, right? All right, so Ghana mothers, right? When you get married, they are like, one thing I like about Ghana is like the culture is like very involving, you know. When you get married, I did not get married in Ghana. My sister got married in Ghana, so I was able to like witness it and everything. And I know people that got married in Ghana, so it's like the whole neighborhood, it's like the whole village will come to the wedding. And then at the wedding, you have your mom is going to advise you, your aunt, if your grandparent. I'm telling you, the whole village of women, or the whole town of women, will come and will tell you how to run your marriage, or how to have a successful marriage, which is really, really good. I don't really see that in America. So, but guess what? I was not an exception. Even though I did not get married in Ghana, believe you me, I got the lecture. All right. So your mom will now call you, be like, okay, so now you are married. You know, you have to always make sure that you have your house is clean, you are taking care of your husband, don't sleep to a like certain time. I'm like, Ma, this is America, you know, this is America. And then she would say, I gave birth to you, you did not give birth to me. Do you want to tell me you know more than, hey, African mothers, don't mess with them, oh. I call my mother the iron lady, the woman with the iron fist. I'm telling you, she's not someone you want to toil with at all. Whatever she says, you have to do it. Okay, sometimes I'm like, oh my goodness, I thank God that she's not here. I mean, I miss her, but I'm like, I thank God I don't live with my mom. Because African mothers, I'm telling you, they don't care whether you're married or unmarried. So they will tell you, you have to wake up certain times and make sure your husband's breakfast is ready. When he comes back from work, you know, ask him how work is, which is seriously logical. If you're a woman and you're married, you are not asking your husband when he comes back from work how his day is, seriously, you need to start doing that. How was your day, honey? Help him take his shoes off, you know? I wouldn't go down to the socks because my husband's feet doesn't stink, so that's a plus. So you can take the shoes off, take the bag, ask him, honey, offer him a glass of water, and that is how the culture is in Ghana. You know, you have to submit to your husband. Now, you know, the word submit has like a negative word to it when it comes to marriage, but you have to submit. Even the Bible says submit. Jesus says we submit, so you have to submit. But back to African mothers, now they will call you, do all that, and make sure you are not starving your husband. I said, I am cooking for him. I loved my mom. My mom would be like, no, that is not the one I'm talking about. Make sure at night you are not starving your husband. I was like, I'm like, I thought that, you know, I'm like, don't go there. They'll be like, don't starve your husband. You know, you have to be available for your husband at night. I'm like, Ma, this is not McDonald's where you want to run a 24-hour shift to. This is marriage. You can be open every night for your husband. Open every night. Open. Nah, not McDonald's. We have to at least incorporate a Chick-fil-A schedule, okay? You'll be like, okay, I'm open Mondays to Friday. I'm closed on Sundays. Guys, you know what I'm trying to say. This is PG-18. Okay? All right, but so that's how African mothers would be like, don't starve your husband at night. Make yourself available to your husband because that is how grandkids come in. Cook for your husband. Make sure you are cleaning. You are doing this. And if you have an African, don't be like, I live in America, because your mother will tell you that I have 8 kids or I had 12 kids and I was still doing all these things. So that is African mothers for you. Be available for your husband. Their perception of being available is like running a McDonald's shift 24/7. And I'm not talking about cooking and cleaning. They're talking about bedroom duties, okay? So I'm like, No, like seriously, no. I mean, nobody got time for that. But just don't tell an African mother that. Just say, okay, ma, I have heard. Don't worry, now it's between you and husband. And one thing they will also tell you is that's my rice cooker. One thing they will also tell you, it's like, do not take your marriage problems like outside. Don't even discuss your marital problems with friends or anybody. Wake your husband up whenever you two have an argument. Wake him up in the middle of the night and apologize. And I'm like, why in the middle of the night? You can apologize any time of the day. But they'll be like, wake your husband up in the middle of the night and apologize because by that time he's relaxed and all that. So if you are from Ghana, I mean, I'm from Ghana, so 100% Ghanaian, GH. All right. I mean, you get the lecture. I'm telling you, your aunt will come and talk to you. Your mom will come and talk. Your grandmother, even your grandfather, if he's alive, he will include himself. Everybody, the whole women, they will gang up and they will come and tell you how to run your home. And honestly, it's not negative, it's all positive, okay? But except for the whole be available for your husband every night, that part, I'm like, pause. Like, seriously, this is not McDonald's. You don't work in any time you want and work out. No, it's not like that. You work, you get tired. And so, you know, your mothers will not get that, but just say yes, ma'am, and move on. And if you are planning to get married to an African woman, welcome to our world, though. You know, welcome to our world. We are very good people. In fact, if you are thinking of getting married to an African woman, by all means, African women are good, though, especially ones that can cook. Don't marry one that wants Brazilian hair today, want to do nails tomorrow, want to spend their whole income or materialistic things. No, stay away from that one, because if you marry that one, you'll never be able to invest or build a better future. Find one that has correct head, correct brains, you know, that thinks about the future. So that is all I have for you guys today. All right, guys, I love you. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please do so. All right, share my videos with others, friends, families, colleagues, lovers, even enemies. Okay, we are not supposed to have enemies, so even share it with enemies. We are not supposed to have enemies. I love you guys. Chop kiss. See you.